Okay, I got asked a really good question yesterday. How does HDSDR track the radio and vice versa? I've got an Icom 7300, but this applies to pretty much any radio that you use an HDSDR with. So I'll show you how I do it, and then a couple of different ways. That's coming up next. Okay, let's get going. HDSDR, if you already got it installed and set up and working, you just want to set it up to track your radio. I'm going to double click on mine, and I have a couple of different EXTIO files. And, you know, there's an easier way to do this, and I'll show you at the end of the video. But this is the one that I'm using. It is for my DX Patrol. There's a few different ways you can use HDSDR in your rig, and my favorite way is DDE to HDSDR. And you can see I have HRD open. It's on the other screen. Drag it over there and show you. Just the rig controls open. You know, I use this window a lot because I have all my sliders on it. I can tune, I can turn off my noise blanker, noise reduction, AGC, turn it off. So, you know, I leave that one open. And, you know, I can also do that from the logbook window, too. DDE to HDSDR, that's a little tricky to say. There's HRD, sync type, tune. And, you know, if you were using Orbitron, and I think that's with Ham Radio Deluxe, you can do that. You can use SAT-PC32 or the Weather Tracker or WISP. I'm not sure even what that is, but there's a few different ones that have the DDE format. You can see that I have a status of OK, and when I click Start, it syncs up with my radio. So if I tune, change frequency on the radio, well, it changes on HDSDR. Boy, I don't know what that stuff is. I'll have to figure that out. And then if I go up here and I use my mouse and I'm changing frequency, or I'm clicking over here, it changes the frequency on my rig. So that works really well. So if you have Ham Radio Deluxe, that's an easy way to do it. Let's go ahead and stop this. Go back to options, and I've got that set up. Let's try Omni-Rig. CAT to radio, and then Omni-Rig. And I'll go to Omni-Rig setup, and it popped up on the other screen, but there it is. My first rig is Icom 7300. I got the port, baud rate 8, and then all of this was the default except RTS, because I'm using the CIV cable. I changed the RTS to low, and it just worked. It didn't work when it was set to high. I don't know what the problem was, but it didn't work. So you go to Omni-Rig and settings, and then really all you have to do is go back to it and make it active. And there you go. Now if I tune, see, I don't even have to start it. If I tune the radio, HDSDR follows, and vice versa. And it goes with mode too. So that's a second way. First way is with a program like Ham Radio Deluxe. Second way is with Omni-Rig. And then there's a third way in here. Let me go in and deactivate this. I don't think it's going to work for me because I was trying it earlier. And CAT to HDSDR. And what's this? HDSDR can get control over a serial CAT interface. Computer-aided transceiver, in case you're wondering. HDSDR understands a small subset of Kenwood's CAT protocol. So maybe it just doesn't work with the Icom 7300. But anyway, I thought I had it working at one time. I set up the port 6, the baud rate, 19.2, and then just CAT only. And then I activate it. And when I activate it, it's fine. But when I turn the dial on the radio, it doesn't follow. And if I select a frequency in HDSDR, the radio doesn't follow. So I don't know what the deal is. If you got the solution, please post it below. Because I thought I did have it working at one time, but maybe it just doesn't work with the Icom radios. Anyway, that's how you do it. Let me go back, and I'm going to deactivate that. And then I'm going to start Ham Radio Deluxe, because I closed it down. And I've got a short delay. But there it goes. Ham Radio Deluxe is running. And then I'll go back to options, DDD to HDSDR. It failed. There it goes. Okay, so when I click start, I've got it. Can you hear that? That's what that is. There it is. I wonder what that is. Plasma TV? Wall wart? Here's some CW. Let me show you a quick way to get rid of that annoying prompt. When you open up HDSDR, it prompts you for the EXTIO file. And I've got two in there. I've got one for the DX Patrol, and I've got one for the RTL-SDR. And most people are probably only going to have one anyway, but if you have two, it'll prompt you. And a good way to do that is to set up profiles. And here's a shortcut. I just created another shortcut on my desktop, right-clicked on it, went down to properties, and in the target, you can see I added at the end, I added a dash P and then the name that I have, DX Patrol, which shows up when I open it up. And then I have the file that I want to use, the EXTIO underscore RTL. So there you go. When I open this one, and I've got it set to start automatically, I'm on 7.128, and I was on 7.74 because I was going to do a little operating FT8, and I wanted to see if I can make some contacts on 40 meters. So you can see that works really well. It tracks my radio. It tracks my radio. My radio will follow HDSDR if I choose to change frequency. Okay, thanks for watching. I hope this helps. And if you have any questions or comments, just make them below. If you like the video, just click the like button. And please subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. 73 and good DX.